My name is Leslie Magaha. I'm with the Southeast Texas Bass Federation. My husband and I are the co-directors for the conservation team here in Southeast Texas. We're fortunate today in that we've got a great partnership with the Boy Scouts, with Texas Parks and Wildlife, with the Stop Aquatic Hitchhikers, Sealy Outdoors, Jackson Hill Marina, Piney Woods Sanitation, a couple of other wonderful sponsors who are helping us come out today, collect the giant Salvinia off of this beautiful lake that we've got behind us with the great intention of keeping it beautiful. We want to make sure that we keep a giant Salvinia in check. We don't want it to get out of control. We're going to keep the hatchery, the water supply, and the ecosystem nice and healthy. The Southeast Texas Bass Federation got involved in this as a function of the fact that bass anglers and anglers and boaters in general are part of the reason why giant Salvinia is escaping to some of these other lakes where it doesn't belong. We would like to keep it from spreading from lake to lake, and the easiest way to do that is for all boaters and anglers to take a look at their boat when they leave a lake, clean it off, take a look inside their live wells, make sure their live wells are cleaned off, take a look around the prop nut, the keel guard, the transducer mounting, take a look around all that stuff. If there's any vegetation, go ahead and take it off. And that way we'll keep from spreading this plant that we don't want to go to these other lakes. The Southeast Texas Bass Federation came into this. Well, part of what started off was an excellent article out of the Houston Chronicle. I had been looking for a conservation project, preferably something that would get some of the anglers out here to take a part in this. Well, here is something that we could really do. This is a project we can get our arms around. Right now, giant Salvinia isn't in Sam Rayburn, as bad as it could be. And it's not here as bad as it is in a lot of other lakes. And by taking a little bit of effort now, we can really keep this from becoming a big problem.
Giant Salvinia is a free-floating aquatic fern from southeastern Brazil that can double the area that it covers in as little as 7 days. So we're looking at trying to prevent an expansion of this plant anywhere that it may occur. Sam Rayburn is a focal point at this time because of its popularity as a largemouth bass lake and its popularity with the tournament anglers throughout the United States. We do not want giant Salvinia to gain a foothold in Sam Rayburn Reservoir, and so therefore an effort like this is really going to help us locate and eliminate the threat.
But this is the most dangerous plant we've got out there right now.
And I mean, it just pretty much wipes out everything underneath it. So all the native plants and the native fish species and the invertebrates and everything have to move away from it. So it basically just creates a desert underneath it.
Giant Salvinia, the hairs on the leaves, as you open the leaf up like this, the hairs on the leaf will be closed like an egg beater. It'll make a little cage-like structure. It's very distinctive. And on common Salvinia, they're going to have a much smaller leaf and sometimes very, very tiny, about the size of a pencil eraser. And if you open up if you can get a good look at the hairs on that leaf, they're forked into a branch of like four small strings. And they're just forked like this. And just remember, if it's closed like an egg beater, that's giant Salvinia.
Okay, this is giant Salvinia. Latin name is Salvinia molesta. It has a close cousin called common Salvinia. And the way that you tell the difference between the two are the leaf hairs on the upper side of the leaf, shown here. The leaf hairs on giant Salvinia form a cage-like structure or an egg beater shape, whereas the leaf hairs on common Salvinia will be branched and open. These structures here that appear like roots are actually modified leaves, and these little tiny nut-like structures are called sporocarps. All of this hangs under the water, whereas all of the green material floats above the water.
So any giant Salvinia you find is going to be very valuable to us because we can go out there and try and eliminate that population right away. If you do find giant Salvinia in anywhere, please, if you have GPS capability, please write down the GPS coordinates so we can find that exact spot, and we will get on top of it as quickly as possible.
You're going to put in right here? Yes. So this side right here?
Right down here. Right down here. Right down here.
Somebody's got to drive.
That's what we figure. One person drive. Oh, man.
You got enough for y'all boat? Get one for our boat.
I'm going to get a workout today.
Yeah, we're going to get you a workout, girl. Pump up your muscles.
We might catch some crawfish, too.
Oh, yeah? Yeah.
You can have a boil tonight.
That's our cabin right there. We see it.
My name is Jimmy Lee, Jr. I'm the North Central Region Conservation Director for B.A.S.S. Federation Nation here in Texas. And this project is the beginning of meaning a lot to anglers and people all over our state of Texas. The state has many treasures, and some of those are our lakes, and the giant Salvinia plant is a threat to our lakes, and with the projection of future population growth, our lakes are going to be even more important for a source of water, and with this invasive aquatic plant, everybody needs to be concerned. Fishermen and members of BASS that I've talked to are united in our concern about eradicating or controlling this aquatic plant.
Hi, my name is Terry Simpson, and I'm with Jackson Hill Park and Marina up here on Lake Sam Rayburn. And a giant Salvinia, what it really means to us as a business is it could devastate a business, and not just devastate a business, but by devastating a fishery and doing the damage that it can do as quickly as it can do it, it really impacts everybody, fishermen, anybody that enjoys the outdoors. But from a business perspective, Sam Rayburn probably generates somewhere around $30 million a year in revenue. And when you think about that amount of recreation, that amount of money involved in the things that we love to do, the impact can be just absolutely devastating. But it's really important that everyone, the public, everyone that enjoys being out on the lake, understands what it is, what it does, and helps keep us abreast of when they find it, so we can do the best we can to keep it out of here.
Efforts to control giant Salvinia are ongoing. We have a very large infestation on Toledo Bend that is being worked with contract herbicide applicators as we speak. And we also are fighting giant Salvinia on Caddo Lake.
We would like to get all anglers to take an active part in watching out for what's on their boat and cleaning up all of the plants that might possibly be on their boat. We really feel that although we can be part of the problem, we can be 100% of the solution.